Hi, we're just going to be looking at dotproject today. This is one of several project management applications that we've reviewed, and it's the one that we're going to be recommending. We also took a very close look at SharePoint, but it doesn't look like we're going to have access to SharePoint services for at least a year yet. So we've decided to go with dotproject. And dotproject is a PHP MySQL application which lives on the web form and therefore lives on web form architecture, which means it's reasonably resilient and backed up. So there are no additional costs to setting up this service. So as the project manager, when you log in, you see this overview in the form of a Gantt chart which shows you where all the current projects are up to and their progress. dotproject is based around the concept of projects, and all projects are owned by a particular company. In this case, we have just one company, which is EPSIS. If we were to roll this out to another organizational unit, we'd have more. So for each of these projects, within them, their development is defined by tasks, and those tasks can be created and assigned to one or more people. Also, for each of those tasks, you can assign resources to them, and resources can be a team, so you could have a potential person from a team, or a resource can be a physical object or a room or something like that. So let's have a look at one of these projects. This is Physics Website Refresh. Now, what we've got here is we've got a number of different tasks, all of which have been assigned to certain people. And if we click on Gantt chart, which is the most easily recognizable view of a particular page, and click Show Full Project, what we can actually see here is the Gantt chart view of the entire project. And we've got all the tasks listed down here. It's displaying what the percentage complete is, and it's showing us where dependencies are here and listing milestones, which is something else you can specify. Now, if I tick on Show Captions and submit, like so, and then just click on Show Full Project again, it will also show me who's been assigned to particular tasks. It's not a great way of looking at it, but it's as good as you'll get in most major systems. So the workflow generally is that a project manager would assign a task to someone, and then that person would log development on their tasks. So I'll just quickly go through that for you. So I click on tasks and I go up to new task, and my task is going to be fix profile code bug. At the moment that's going to be active, and I'm already actually working on that, so I'm going to set it at 40% complete. It's not a milestone, and the priority is just normal. So if I look at the other, I can put some descriptions down here for more detail if I need to. So I need to assign some dates to that. So click on the dates tab, pop a date in here. I'm going to work on it from the 11th to the 14th, and I'm expecting it to take 8 hours to fix. So I look at dependencies, and what I can do here is, if I had several other projects, project tasks, which had to be completed before this one, I could assign them to this, and then the system would become aware of it, and I could do some tracking around that. I don't have any dependencies for this, so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to click on Human Resources, and we're going to have a couple of people working on this, myself and Kevin. And if we go to other resources here, there are we could add elements from a team, or we could have additional resources like, say, a multimedia computer or a laptop assigned to this task. Okay, so just checking back there. Now I click Save. And that task now appears here. And the system will keep a track of that and notify me when it's overdue and so on. And if I was to log in now that it's been assigned to me, like this one has, as a user. Oh, sorry, we've got details there about who it's been assigned to. The system would show me what tasks I have waiting for me, and I'll show you that in a moment. So let's just go back to the Gantt chart view. So I can see that Kevin and I are working on that task there, and I can look at it in relation to all the other tasks. Now, before I was to do that, what I could do is I could go to the tasks overview section, and I could look at a particular user. Let's pick Kevin. And I could see what other tasks he's assigned to. And when Kevin logged in, he would get these tasks. As you can see, you can filter it to say unfinished tasks or particular projects. And you can also search for a particular element of tasks. Say you could put the word programming in there to bring up all your development tasks. So once you're working on a particular task, let's go into the project view again. Bring that project up. Once you're working on a particular task, to let the project manager know what's going on, you can log your work in a particular task. So, fix profile display bug. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a log item there. And we've got details about, I'm just going to say I spent an hour doing this. Don't need to fill that information in because we don't use it. And what I'm going to put in here is I'm just going to put reviewed XSLT. And when the project manager comes along to look at how task development is going on, he can see that I've put a log in there. And if I want to, that's changed the percentage of completion, I can make a small alteration to that if need be. So I've done this particular task and I now estimate that it's 55% complete. When I view the project, go to the Gantt chart, we can see that this issue is now showing that it's 55% complete when we look at the overview. So, other things that might be useful in this particular system. If I was an overall manager looking at all the IT projects, I can click on the Gantt chart here to see everything that's going on, and there's lots of stuff I can do around filtering that and showing particular tasks for a project, but obviously it can get so complicated that you can't actually work out what's going on. There is a system in here called Project Designer, and that's like a command console for a particular project. So if I select a project here, this is a project that's been run by Gerald, and we can see here there are quite a few tasks, and Gerald can create new tasks and make alterations here all from a single user interface if he so wishes to. It's important to point out here that one thing that Gerald's done with this particular project is he's created tasks which are the children of other tasks, and these tasks change dynamically depending on the development of the task beneath them. So that's a good way to manage subtasks on a project. Finally, if you want to, you can click on history here, which basically runs through and gives you details of who's done what. There's also a security system within this application, but we're going to be working initially, certainly on a trust basis, assuming that someone's not going to go and vandalize a particular project. So if you've got any questions about this, if you just contact me and I'll show you through it. Thank you for your time.